world's waste. I am a mountain, I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind, sweeping the country. I am a river, down in the valley, oh, I am a vision, I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of...
It's another beautiful Friday. You all welcome to Shade. The Harmattan is here. I hope everybody is keeping warm. Well, today on Shade, we'll be talking autoimmune disease. And of course, there is a doctor in the house that we trash all the questions that I will present to him today. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this episode of Shadi. Welcome back. Like I said earlier on, that we'll be talking about autoimmune disease today, and I have in the studio with me Dr. Akeem Olaosebikan, the senior registrar in Lagos State University Teaching Hospital. Dr. Olaosebikan, you're welcome to Shade.
Good evening, viewers.
You're welcome to Shade. Thank you for coming to Shade. Autoimmune disease. Can you please define autoimmune disease?
Thank you for inviting me to your program. Autoimmune disease or disorders or conditions are a group of diseases that are characterized by abnormal reaction of our body. Mm-hmm. You know, in a way that our body tends to be, the body produces some proteins called antibody that tends to attack the body. The body itself produces these proteins called antibodies, mm-hmm. but this antibody can ordinarily supposed to protect us against germs and infections, supposed to protect us against developing diseases, but for no reason these antibodies. Now, start attacking the body that is supposed to protect. In that way, these antibodies can attack the skin, can attack the joint, it can attack the brain, the heart, the lungs, and any part of the body can actually be affected by these antibodies, leading to, diseases.
What are the causes of this? I mean, why should...
Actually, there are no causes for autoimmune disease.
Okay.
That's we don't have specific, causes for these autoimmune diseases.
Mm.
But there are theories that have been postulated. There are theories that people have suggested.
Suggested.
And those theories, include some risk factors.
Okay.
That is certain things that tends to increase the chance of developing autoimmune diseases.
What are some of these risk factors?
We can start from the sex, being female.
Okay.
The female sex, they have more higher risk of developing autoimmune diseases than being male. And that is why about 2/3 of autoimmune diseases are found among female than male.
Why?
Because the reason is that the researchers have shown that women actually produce some chemical called hormones,
okay,
which tends to actually stimulate the immune system.
Mm-hmm.
And when this happens, the immune system, these hormones is called estrogen.
Mm-hmm.
Estrogen is a chemical, is an hormone in the body that makes you female.
Okay.
So, but this estrogen, which is the chemical or the hormones, now it has some and immune properties.
Okay.
And that is why women are more predisposed to developing autoimmune disease than men.
Okay.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Then the other issue is that autoimmune disease are also, the other risk factor include age.
Mm-hmm.
It's commonly found among younger or reproductive age group.
Mm.
compared to elderly patients.
Okay.
So people within the reproductive age bracket, they are more likely to develop autoimmune disease than people outside that range.
Bracket.
However, autoimmune disease can also affect any age group. It can affect neonates, that is, infants. It can affect elderly. Mm. But commonly, it's found within that reproductive age group bracket. Mm. Then the other risk factors for autoimmune disease can also be genetics. That is what we mean by genetics, is that people, they have this genetic risk. That is, you have there is a factor within you that tends to, increase your risk of having autoimmune disease. It is something that you are born with. That is genetic. Mm. So that is why some women in reproductive age may not develop autoimmune. There are some will develop.
Mm.
Some women, it's like, for example, lung cancer. Some people smoke heavily and they don't develop lung cancer. For example. Mm-hmm. But people that do not smoke, they still develop lung cancer. You understand? So it is the genes that determines that. So some people, they have that genetic propensity to develop what? Autoimmune disease than other people.
But that doesn't mean that smoking is a positive thing.
Well, for autoimmune disease, smoking is also a risk factor for autoimmune, especially rheumatoid arthritis.
Okay.
Rheumatoid arthritis is a form of autoimmune disease.
Okay.
It involves, antibody attacking the joints.
Okay.
Joint become painful, swollen, and stiff. You understand? Mm. And so the smoking has been found to be a risk factor for rheumatoid arthritis, which is a form of autoimmune diseases.
Okay. Now, you just mentioned rheumatoid arthritis now as a type of... Are there other types of autoimmune diseases?
Yes. There are more than 80 types of autoimmune diseases.
Wow.
Yes, more than 80 types. And it can be divided into two.
Groups.
There are two groups. There are those that affect just single organs or single part of the body. You understand?
What do you
just
mean by
one.
Single?
That is
okay,
one part of the body.
Okay.
And there are those that affect multiple parts of the body at the same time.
Mm.
For example, if somebody can develop skin problem, which is just in that skin, it will not affect any other part of the body. That can be also due to, like, what it causes, there's a disease called psoriasis. It's a skin disease.
Okay.
And it's an autoimmune disease. You understand?
Mm.
It just affects the skin. But really, does it affect other parts of the body except the skin? Occasionally, it can affect the joints.
Mm.
You understand? So that is like an organ specific. That it affects one part, like diabetes.
Mm.
A form of diabetes is an autoimmune disease.
Mm.
And it affects an organ inside our body called pancreas. It's inside our body. So that is an organ specific. That is, meanwhile, some autoimmune disease, like, for example, lupus. Lupus is an autoimmune that can affect multiple parts of our body, both external or internal part of our body, at the same time.
Hmm.
It can affect the skin, it can affect the joints, it can affect the eye, it can affect the heart, the lungs.
Any part of the
at
body.
At the same time. And that one is more of life-threatening.
Hmm.
You understand? So, however, we cannot now say that we are more than 80 types. I can't list all the 80 types. But commonly, the one that everybody
is rampant.
Diabetes, everybody know diabetes.
Mm-hmm.
A form of diabetes, we call it type 1 diabetes.
Okay.
It has an autoimmune component. Asthma is a form of autoimmune disease, and everybody has asthma. However, there are some autoimmune diseases that people don't recognize. Even doctors.
Mm.
And those one are quite common.
Mm.
That one include rheumatoid arthritis.
Mm-hmm. Which affects
the joints. It can also affect the eyes, the heart, the lungs, it can affect the skin. But most importantly, the primary site that it affects is the joints.
Mm.
The joints will become painful, will become swollen, will become stiff, and the pain usually was early in the morning. You understand? That patients find it difficult to get out of bed.
Mm.
They actually crawl out of bed.
Very excruciating.
And very excruciating
pain.
As the day progresses, they may feel better.
Mm.
That is the typical way rheumatoid arthritis presents. And this morning stiffness, joint stiffness, can last more than 30 minutes.
Mm.
You understand?
Mm.
That is weird. But however, they can also have some other complaints. Generally, all autoimmune disease, they can have complaints such as they can have recurrent fever. That is, like if you have malaria, typhoid, but it's not malaria, it's not typhoid. You've done the malaria, you've been treated with malaria severally, you are still having the same complaint.
Mm.
you suspect autoimmune disease.
Mm.
You'll be treated with typhoid on, and you still continue to have the same symptoms. And HIV, which is common, has been ruled out or has been excluded.
Mm-hmm.
And you are still having the same symptoms if you could have an autoimmune disease.
Mm.
So usually, it's more of a typical young lady, you know, who has lost some weight,
mm-hmm.
who has been having on and on malaria type, we call it malaria typhoid syndrome. Mm. That is malaria today, typhoid tomorrow. Malaria today, typhoid tomorrow. And you've done malaria tests, you've used malaria drugs, you've used typhoid drugs, and you are still having the same symptoms. You suspect autoimmune disease.
Mm.
Another thing is that they get tired easily.
Mm.
You know, they get small things, they get so tired.
Mm.
Sometimes they have this feeling of unwell.
Mm.
Some of them may have a rash. Especially the rash may be on their face, you know. And some, their symptoms may get worse when they're exposed to sun. Especially if it's that lupus I talk about.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? These are the way the patient present. But usually a young lay woman within the reproductive age bracket with fever, on and on fever, malaria, typhoid syndrome, you know, they get tired easily, as I said.
Mm-hmm.
They can have skin rash, they can have joint pain. Before you now start having other symptoms, depending on the organs, that the part of the body that is affected.
Mm-hmm. Is there any other sign that one will see? Because as you rightly defined now, it's something that is within the system.
Yes.
Is there any other sign apart from skin, apart from the joints, any other sign that one...
Actually, the symptoms or the signs of autoimmune disease that you see or that the patient has depends on the type of autoimmune disease that you have. That's one. It also depends on the organs or the part of the body that are affected.
Okay.
For example, diabetes is an autoimmune disease.
Mm-hmm.
What the problem is that people start having, they urinate more frequently. They have persistent taste. They want to drink, that ability to drink a lot of water. You know, that is for diabetes. That means a lupus patient may not have that. Rheumatoid arthritis may not have that.
Mm.
So the other things they can have depend on the type. There's another one called systemic sclerosis.
Okay.
I don't want to use too medical jargon, which is a form of autoimmune disease that associated with skin thickening. The skin will become so thickened, and you know, become so hard, adding skin. You understand that they cannot actually open their mouth very well. They can't swallow.
Wow.
They have difficulty with breathing and all those things. That's a form of autoimmune disease too. But predominantly, it affects the skin, and it can also affect internal organs, internal part of the body.
Body.
So if the lung is affected, definitely they will have problem. They will be coughing. When they walk, they feel breathless.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So sometimes they can have chest pain. If the heart is affected, they can also start coughing. They also feel breathless. Their leg can be swollen.
Swollen.
The face can be swollen if the kidney is involved. So any part of the body
can be affected
by autoimmune disease. Mm. Even the brain.
Mm.
You understand?
Mm.
Brain can be affected. The eyes, people can go blind from autoimmune disease.
Wow.
You understand? So, and autoimmune disease can actually cause recurrent pregnancy loss because the antibodies see the baby inside the womb as a foreign body.
Body and attacks it.
And attack it.
Mm.
You know, I said normally antibody, what it does normally is to protect us.
Mm.
Protect us against germs, against infections, against developing diseases. For no reason, it now sees this part of the body as a foreign thing.
Mm.
As, you know, it's like Nigerian soldiers killing Nigerian citizens. So our antibodies, they are our body soldiers.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So to protect us. So if once Nigerian soldiers killing us means that it's just like the way the antibodies also behave when they
attacking itself.
Yes, when so it's attacking itself.
Mm.
So it depends on the part of the body that is affected. So we can't really see the lot of symptoms or signs. It depends on the disease, the type of autoimmune disease that you have.
Mm-hmm.
It also depends on the organ that is involved. You understand? If somebody, I recently had a patient in last week that presented with difficulty arising from prolonged sitting. Let's say that as we have, you know, also difficulty combing her hair or tying her head gel.
Mm-hmm.
That one now, the autoimmune disease affects the muscles, you know, in this place, the body. The muscle of the hip.
Mm.
And the muscle of the shoulder. So the person cannot stand up until you help the person.
Mm.
And then the person cannot actually use her hand because of the The autoimmune disease affects, it's not the pain now. Mm-hmm. The autoimmune disease affects the muscles. The muscles in the shoulder and the muscle in the what? In the hip. The world's greatest.